tonight and have a good spirit, you may be seated. If you're not going to help me preach, then remain standing so I know who to preach to. Amen. My message tonight, for those of you that are sort of worried about titles, my message tonight is entitled, There's a Miracle in Your Mouth. I want you to look at your neighbor right now, look him dead in the eye, and say, there's a miracle in your mouth. Shake the person on the other side of you gently, don't hurt him or nothing, and say, there's a miracle. Don't tell them it would be a miracle if you'd shut your mouth. Say, there's a miracle in your mouth. Amen. Give God a praise right now. Seemed like he was being supportive, but Jesus spun around and he looked at Peter and he said, Satan, get thee behind me. He identified the spirit that was manifesting itself. He wasn't saying that Peter was the devil. He was saying the devil is using your mouth to manifest his will into this earth. The Bible says when the disciples encountered a group that was not with them, they said, Lord, there are people over here preaching in your name. Should we stop them? And Jesus said, if they're not against us, they're for us. Leave them alone. I'd love to preach on that tonight, but I'll resist the urge. He said, leave them alone. And they said, Lord, you don't understand. Maybe you ought to call fire down out of heaven and consume them. And Jesus said, ye know not what spirit you are of. You don't understand the spirit that you are manifesting right now into the natural world. The spirit world is invisible, physical ailment, but there was a spiritual malady that the Bible said had shriveled her up and crippled her. And Jesus loosed her from the spirit of infirmity. I don't know all that it was, but their tradition said that until a man was 30 years old, he could not work in ministry. This was Jesus' first year of ministry. And if you count it back, if Jesus was 30 when he healed the woman, if you count it back, it says she was sick for 18 years. 18 years earlier, Jesus had been in the very temple that she came and got healed in 18 years later. And whatever it was, their tradition did not allow her to believe that a 12-year-old boy who was confounding the Pharisees and the Sadducees and the teachers of the law said, we won't receive your ministry until you're 30. And so she suffered for 18 years because of the bondage and the tradition of the law. I tell you tonight, there is no law keeping you from getting your miracle. There is no law. There is no tradition keeping you from having revival. Back into the spirit, and he has not been able to do it until the Bible says in the book of John, chapter 1, in the beginning was the Word. That word is logos. It doesn't just mean word. It does mean word, but it means more than word. It means in the beginning God had a thought. In the beginning God had an intent. In the beginning God had an idea. In the beginning, God had a feeling. And that feeling, that thought, that intent, the literal definition, one of the literal definitions of logos is voice. In the beginning, God had a voice. And the voice was with God. And the voice was was God, and the voice became flesh and dwelt amongst us, and we beheld his glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Regardless of your interpretation, there can be no doubt that in the book of Hebrews chapter 1 and verse 3, it tells us that Jesus is the substance. He is the express image of the invisible God. Shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe those things which he saith shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he saith. Put another way, there's a miracle in your mouth. That's why the Bible says that faith calleth those things which be not as though they were. That's why the Bible says that he upholdeth all things by the word of his power. That's why the Bible says heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. That's why the Bible says it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. I'm telling you, the centurion said, only speak the word, and my servant shall be healed. There's a miracle. There's a miracle. Say it with me right now. There's a miracle in my mouth.